With one of them, Jose Manuel Barroso, president of the European Commission.
Because at past meetings that we've seen at IMF or G20 high-profile meetings, Europe has been at the forefront, particularly the concerns about the economic crisis. Five bailouts, unemployment is rising, growth is lacking. So I talked to Jose Manuel Barroso, the EU president, about the progress they've made. This is really their new talking point. Here's what he says.
I think I can say that the existential crisis to the euro is now behind us. Yes, we may have some problems or some accidents, but we are now better equipped than before. There is now more confidence. If you think, because we have spoken sometime, let's say 1 year ago before, people were speaking about the implosion of the euro. Yeah. This is no longer the, let's say, the analysis. The euro, by the way, remains a very strong and stable currency. So I think this overall there is more confidence. The problems that we have seen in Cyprus that have not basically shaken that confidence. But we should avoid any kind of complacency. We should now work with a more speedy way, in a more speedy way, to have the banking union in place and to complete our work.
Perhaps it would be more helpful to have a weaker euro. Perhaps the euro is too strong when it comes to growth, you say, which is one of the main priorities.
It's true what you say, that in some areas in Europe, people would prefer to have another exchange rate for the euro. What I want to underline is that basically the price stability is a great, let's say, advantage, and that shows that in spite of all the difficulties that we have been facing, overall, the euro remains a very strong and stable currency, and this is good in terms of stability.
But do you worry at all about two different Europes, that the economic divide right now between the north and the periphery could lead to a cultural divide as well?
Yes, that is a matter of concern for me, because by definition, what I want is the unity of Europe, and that is our first task, and it has been very challenging, because the reality is that we don't have in Europe a completely unified, let's say, financial culture. We know that. Mm-hmm. So this is very challenging. So I think it's up to the leaders now to explain what's at stake, to explain that it is in our interest to achieve common goals.
And Eric, I thought this was particularly interesting and candid, this point. He says he does worry about what's happening. Two-speed Europe, economic divides, and sort of the cultural differences that are coming out of this. The northern countries blaming the southern countries for irresponsibility, and the southern countries blaming the northern countries for being harsh creditors. So that's certainly one point that he's worried about. Still, he says the euro is cohesive. We're not sitting here talking about the implosion of the currency, and that existential threat is behind us.
To what degree does Barroso speak for Germany?
Well, he doesn't speak for Germany. He speaks for Brussels, the European Union, the European Commission. It's a struggle because he has to deal with 17 nations,
right. I
17
asked because,
governments.
You know, the Germans
they're in charge.
The Germans are still, and they're still speaking out. Wolfgang Schäuble, the finance minister, over the weekend saying that, you know, Europe needs to take an approach towards bank bailouts, not all that different, say, from what they did in Cyprus, which is not to say that they want to go and haircut depositors, but they want it to be a bail-in that equity holders and debt holders and not national governments would need to do the bailing out. And that seems to be a dividing line between Germany
just
and the
one,
rest of Europe.
Just one dividing line. And that is what President Barroso's job is, to unify the message that has been botched in the media, in press conferences, you name it, from Europe. It's been one of their biggest problems to begin with. And that's why they're trying to hone this message ahead of these key international meetings. Progress. And they have made progress if you step back. So.
But is the existential crisis really a thing of the past?
We will see.
All in the
eye of the beholder.